Hey, how's it going? This is Elite G, and welcome to the Beginner's Guide. This game isn't too long, I think it's like an hour and a half. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to throw the whole thing up there, and then put, you know, little parts, one part one, part two, you know, in case anyone just don't have the time to watch the whole thing. But anyway, this game was made by Davey Whedon, I believe that's how you pronounce his last name. The guy who created the Stanley Parable, which is a pretty funny game, so I'm guessing this game should be about the same. So I say we go ahead and check this game out and see exactly what it's about. I'm pretty sure audio is on. I can hear some bird chirping. Okay, WASD and left mouse. Pretty simple.
Hi there. Thank you very much for playing The Beginner's Guide.
Oh, you're welcome.
My name is Davey Reedon. I wrote The Stanley Parable,
as I said.
And while that game tells a pretty absurd story, today I'm going to tell you about a series of events that happened between 2008 and 2011.
Okay.
We're going to look at the games made by a friend of mine named Coda. Now, these games mean a lot to me. I met Coda in early 2009 at a time when I was really struggling with some personal stuff, and his work pointed me in a very powerful direction. I found it to be a good reference point for the kinds of creative works that I wanted to make.
Okay.
So just to start you off, this is, I think, the first game he ever made. It's a level for Counter-Strike.
Huh.
You can walk around here, by the way. And mostly it's just Coda learning the basics of building a 3D environment. But what I like is that even though he starts from the simple aesthetic of a desert town, he then scatters these colorful abstract blobs and impossible floating crates around the level. And of course, it destroys the illusion that this actually is a desert town.
Yeah,
instead,
kind of.
This level becomes a kind of calling card from its creator. It's like a reminder that this video game was constructed by a real person. And it kind of makes you wonder, what was going through his head as he was building this? This is what I like about all of Coda's games. I mean, not that they're all fascinating as games, but that they are all going to give us access to their creator. I want us to see past the games themselves. I want to get to know who this human being really is. And that's exactly what we're going to do here.
Okay. Well,
so,
this...
It's 2008.
Different type of game I've played.
Games, and he never releases any of them. He doesn't put them onto the internet. He just makes them and then immediately abandons them, and they sit on his computer forever. And I think he really understood this image of himself as a recluse. At one point, he jokingly renamed his computer's recycling bin to Important Games Folder. So, you know, this was just how he worked. He tended to crank them out one after the other without even really pausing to try to understand what he had just made. Until suddenly one day, he just stopped. In 2011, that was it. He made his last game, and then he hasn't made another one since.
Huh.
And that's why I've taken this opportunity to gather all of his work together, is because I find his games powerful and interesting, and I'd like this collection to reach him, to maybe encourage him to start creating again. And if the people like you who play this also happen to find his work interesting, then I'm sure it'll just send that much stronger of a message of encouragement to Coda. So thanks for joining me on this. If you have a particular interpretation that I haven't mentioned here, or if you just need to get in touch, you can email me at daveywreden@gmail.com.
Okay.
Okay, that's about it for introduction. Let's take a look at Coda's first proper game. As each game is loading, I'll show you the date that it was completed. This first one was made in November 2008.
So, is this actually a game, or is it just trying to get his buddy Coda to get his game started again? Because this is strange. Oh. I got no sound.
This game is called Escape from Whisper, and it's one of the more generic games you'll see from Coda.
Okay. Got no sound? Okay, goodbye. I can't reload. Oh shit. I hope this ain't bad. I can't reload.
Security call breached. Hostile
entity life form. Oh no. Oh no.
It kinda looks like this game was abandoned mid-development. For instance, you have this gun, which you'd think would indicate that there are supposed to be monsters or enemies somewhere. But then clearly there are no enemies anywhere.
Huh.
You can't even reload the gun when you run out of bullets. But ultimately we don't really know. Maybe Coda thought that actually it was complete the way that it is. And I think that we should talk about his games for what they are, rather than for what they're not.
Enemy force neutralized. Begin shooting detonation.
And what I think is,
I love how you can see the bottom of the universe from this room.
Well, I think he's like just gonna go back and fix all these little problems. I mean, it's not a finished game or anything, so I think that's not a big deal, you know, because the no bullets, a little bug, you just fix later.
Apparently, this space station has a labyrinth on it.
What?
Sure, I don't know. There's really no reason for it that I've ever been able to discern, so in the interest of time, I'm just gonna skip you on past it.
No! I wanted to do it! Ah, okay.
Okay, this is the part that's interesting. The game has this narrative about the Whisper Machine and how it has to be turned off, and then you get to the engine room.
Okay. Is that it?
Hey! You there, in the engine room. You could save us all. That beam is powering the Whisper Machine. We could disrupt it by introducing a great enough heat signature. If you... your body could stop the beam.
What?
It's so much to ask, but for all of our lives, would you do it? Could you give yourself?
I'd be like, hell no. Get your ass down and do it yourself. But since it's a game, I guess I'd be...
Let me pause here for a second.
Okay.
What you just experienced, stepping into the beam and then dying, is probably what Coda had initially intended when he was developing this level. But when he first compiles and plays it, something goes wrong. There's a bug somewhere. And this is what happens instead.
I get respawned? That's it? I just have to keep jumping into the beam. Oh. Oh. I can see the edge of the universe.
The beam causes you to start floating. And this is an important moment for him. Because yes, this is technically a glitch, but Coda identifies something human about it. Like how small it makes you feel in the face of this larger chaotic system. Or this floating could be the afterlife, a peaceful place, juxtaposed against all of the hysteria that you've just had to traverse. I don't even know. I have no idea what he was thinking, but what's clear is that after making this, something lodges itself in his brain. He wants to do more of these really weird and experimental designs. So he stops work on this and moves on to a stream of tiny little games that go in all sorts of directions. Let's go ahead and take a look at the first game he made after leaving this one behind.
Maybe he got bored. Like you said, it's a generic shooting game. Really?
Yep. In this game, you can only walk backwards.
Oh, that's a bit... The pass was behind her.
So it's a short and relatively minimalist experiment combining motion and narrative. It is less advanced than the previous game, but actually it seems to be more focused, more complete.
Okay.
Code is trying to give it a unique voice rather than simply basing it on a pre-existing trope.
The past was behind her, but the future could not be seen. Why does the future keep changing? Okay. Huh. When she stops and looks, it becomes clear. But if the future is always behind her, how has she found the strength? to confront it.
It's a short little thought, it says what it wants to say, and then it ends. Didn't need anything more than that. Which to me is why it works, because it gets out quick. Okay, next one.
I don't know, that was different. It was kind of interesting. I like that. Uh-oh.
You are now entering...
And that's it.
What?
Okay, the meaning of this game won't be clear just yet. Please be patient with me for a few more games, and I promise you'll see what makes it interesting.
Huh, okay.
Nonsense. Oftentimes, Coda would put bizarre titles like this one at the start of his games.
Nonsense in nearly every direction. I'm guessing you want me to
hit
up there.
I wish I'd known him at the time that he was making these early games. He would really only talk to me about his work as he was making it. Once he stopped work on a game, like, that was it. It was dead to him. And I don't agree with that at all, but what are you gonna do?
Maybe he get bored and what?
Once you've been slowed to an absolute crawl, the door at the top of the stairs opens. So why, if Coda's not showing these games to anyone, why bother opening the door at all? Well, to show you, I'm modifying the game here so that when you press enter, it'll bring you back up to full speed so you can enter the door for yourself.
I will make it without your help. Go, sucker, go. Go, sucker, go. Go, sucker, go. Am I going faster like this? I don't know. It might be. Actually, I think I am. I don't know if I am, but it looks like I am. Go, 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 go. Well, he should have slowed you down a lot faster if he didn't want no one to come to the ramp, to the room and see what's in there. I made it! That wasn't too bad. Yeah, jumping is a lot faster. I do not need to press your... I do not need to cheat in these games. You walk around talking people down from pursuing their hopes and dreams. What? The game is nothing but giant blocks of text explaining what's happening.
A room that's warm and nice and filled with little ideas for games.
Normal game where you have to scream into the mic every 15 seconds to play. You are a gate.
Coda would often tell me that he didn't mind if people thought of him as cold or distant. He said that he knew that he was actually a vibrant and compassionate person, but that it takes time to really see that. It can be a very slow climb to get there.
Ah. Socks are trying to eat you. Simultaneously, you are trying to eat the sharks. I see. I get it going up like that. Ready, set, fish! This doesn't look like a fishing game to me. Why do you say fish?
Well, this is new for Coda. It's an actual puzzle.
Is it?
Go ahead and see if you can solve it.
Don't get stuck. Okay, yeah.
Don't forget that solution, because we're going to see this puzzle again soon.
Simple
enough.
We're
going to see it a lot.
Okay.
So that seems to be it, right? You walk down a corridor, you solve a puzzle, you get to the end. Simple enough. All right. Now I'm going to modify the game again, so that when you press enter, it'll remove all of the walls from this room.
Alright. I guess I got no choice but to press enter. Holy shit.
How about that? There was more to it than we had any way of knowing.
Holy shit.
I actually find it funny that this game comes after the stairs game, since they essentially convey the opposite idea. So, in the stairs game, a dull exterior concealed a rich interior. And then, in this level, a dull interior hides this fantastic outer world. Either way, I think that the point is the same, is that most of the time, you don't get to know what you're missing, or even that you're missing anything. That's not your role as a player. So if your role here is not to understand, then what is it?
It's to play the games that the creator makes. We're back here again. What? You're now exiting?
Aha. So, this, combined with the entering game from earlier, tells us that Coda believes his games are connected somehow. It could even be that the stairs game and the puzzle game are literally connected in between this and the entering game. There's a bigger picture that all of his games are meant to play a role in, some larger meaning that we won't be able to grasp until we've seen all of them. And once we have, we can step back and start to understand what exactly that bigger picture is.
Okay. Maybe just games that he didn't... I don't know this guy, but... The Great and Lovely Descent. Oh my god, that is bright. I guess I'm going through the house. I can travel up to White Hills, but pretty sure there's nothing up
there.
Let's
talk about video game development for a second.
Okay.
Every video game runs on what's called an engine, which determines what the game can and cannot do.
Correct.
So in other words, the engine is a set of tools for game development.
Okay.
To make all of these games, Coda is using an engine called Source. Like all engines, Source has certain things that it does well, and it has things that it does poorly. One of the things that it does very well is boxy linear corridors.
Shit!
That's why so many of Coda's games are set large, flat, empty rooms, is just because he's working with what the engine does well. The tools available to the creator shape what kinds of creative work they're going to end up making. You might consider paying attention to the architecture in Coda's games, to notice how they seem to stem from an engine that's very good at producing linear, boxy corridors.
I see. I guess I'm just going this way. Guess there's no fall damage. I thought I was dead. I really did. I thought I was screwed. What is this, a prison? Alright. Is that my cell? So I'm not special enough to get the first floor. I get the third floor. Well, no.
This prison, funny enough, in Coda's original design, the door stayed shut for a full hour before letting you go. If you don't mind, I think we're gonna skip that.
Yes, thank you.
This is something that he and I used to argue about a lot. You know, whether a game ought to actually be playable, whether it means anything if no one can get through it. And I would always defend that, you know, all this work goes into the game, why not make it playable and accessible? And so we just got into heated arguments over it, and there was one time that after one of these conversations, he went home, and a day or two later, he sent me a zip file entitled Playable Games that was full of hundreds of individual games, each of which was just an empty box that you walked around in and nothing else. Believe me, I played every single one of those just to find out if there was like a gag hidden somewhere. There wasn't.
Oh, he got you good. Well, I mean, I create videos, and I got a lot of videos that I've done, and quite a few that I haven't actually put out, pretty much just for my entertainment. And what's with these holes? It's like the third time I've seen them. All right. I mean...
It's the puzzle again, with the exact same solution as the last time.
He just feel like, you know, making these games for fun. It's a hobby, like,
there's
what I do.
There's still no clear indication of what makes this puzzle so special that Coda is going to return to it over and over. But I promise, I'll share with you my interpretation very shortly.
I see the itch again. Okay. Why would he make... I don't know. It's a simple little puzzle that made no sense to me to have. Listen. You there, did you come from up
here,
above?
Here, Kuda begins using a kind of dialogue system that he fashioned out of the engine's chat capabilities. Use the 1, 2, 3 buttons on your keyboard to respond.
I can kind of figure that out. What was up there? Wall stamp of whiteness. Yes, there was an enormous prison. I spent hours. Let's go with the whiteness. That's the world above. You been there? Now, this is important. Did you have to get through a puzzle with 2 doors and switches? Yes, I did. That was literally the last thing I did before coming here. Again, perfect. Now please, tell us how you solved it. Tell us the solution. Tell us how to get to the other side. I do remember someone that... Trust me. You don't want to go over there. Oh no, but I do. We do. We need to get there. Do you understand? It is the most important thing in the world. We have to escape this prison. There must be an ending. I promise you, there's nothing I want more. Okay. Hello, how did you get here? Was there a puzzle you had to pass through? Yes. Do you want to know how to solve it? No. We actually find the black space between the doors to be far more interesting. Have you seen it yet? Why would I care about the space between the doors? There is a reason, but it may take time before you understand, which is fine. You'll see soon enough. Huh.
And so we make one last descent down to the final floor of the level.
Okay. It's a lamppost.
It's a lamppost. Okay, I can't tell you quite why, but for some reason, Kuda fixates on this lamppost. It's going to appear at the end of every single one of his games from here on out. I'll tell you what I think. I think that up to this point, you know, he's been making really strange and abstract games with no clear purpose, and maybe you can only float around in that headspace for so long. Because now he wants something to hold on to. He wants a reference point. He wants the work to be leading to something. He wants a destination, which is what this lamppost is. It's a destination. We're going to see it in the work as well. His games are just going to become a lot more cohesive, a lot more fully developed, with more of a clear idea behind them. And as we go, that idea will get clearer and clearer and clearer.
Okay. April 2009. This game is connected to the internet. As you walk around, you can leave notes. All notes you see have been left by other players. I really doubt that. Why is it always looking up to the left? It did that in the other game. Nice room, not.
So first off, I'm sure you can deduce this, but this game is not connected to the internet.
Yeah,
all of the notes
that
you're going to see have been written by Kuda. This was actually the first game of his that I ever played. This was shortly after I met him at a weekend game jam in Sacramento, where I grew up. I saw him working on this very level, and it was just so different from anything that anyone else was doing. So right away I was like, I have to be friends with this person.
Huh.
In retrospect, I think I was probably a bit too pushy trying to get his attention. I was over-enthusiastic. But he was very gracious about it and very patient with me. And I cooled off eventually.
Eventually.
Oh, feel free to skip over any of these notes if they're not doing anything for you. Nothing extra is going to happen if you read all of them. Either way, to me they convey a sense of loneliness. I see this person who's filled with thoughts and feelings and beliefs and has no way to express them except as scattered and unheard voices in a game that wasn't meant to be played. But it's ironic, isn't it, that in playing this game and seeing how alone Coda often felt, that we get to know him better and actually kind of connect with him. And I have to be honest with you, this idea is really seductive to me, that I could just play someone's game and see the voices in their head and get to know them better and have to do less of the messy in-person socializing. I could just get to know you through your work. I think this is why I always liked Coda's games so much, is because it felt like they let me have that connection. I felt as though he was inviting me personally into his world. And then I feel less lonely too.
Okay. Sean and read this, but then he's talking. You can't know someone just by doing their work. I mean, if you want to be their friend, you did all that trouble to try to, you know, be his friend. Hold on, let me get this down. Okay, like I was saying, you can't know someone by their work. If you did all this thing just to be their friend and everything, but I don't know. Oh, there's a shitload. I'm going to read them all. So, what I'm going to do now is speed up. So you don't have to sit here forever, you know. Whatever. If you want to skip it, I guess it's going to be like a couple minutes at supersonic speed. But anyway, yeah. Here we go.
This level, we're going to see the puzzle again, and here I'll tell you what I think the puzzle means.
Okay.
Each of these games represents an idea that was on Coda's mind at the time that he was making it, and the puzzle is a way of closing the door on a previous chapter of his life before moving on to the next one.
What? Is it really that deep to do that? I don't think it is.
In each of his games, after exploring a theme that, you know, he might find difficult, Coda can then place this puzzle that he knows has a reliable solution, he understands exactly how it works, and so it gives him a simple mechanism for moving on.
Really? Hop.
And because there's this dark area between the doors, a space between spaces, before you move on, you get to pause. Just for a moment, a few seconds to reflect on and let go of the events that led you here. To step back and connect the pieces together, to grasp at that elusive bigger picture.
Really? I don't know. I don't know, this seems kind of strange to me. How do you leave notes? Ha! Holy shit. Why is it so loud? Okay, I understand. Are you there? Please say something. It can be anything. I just need you to say something. Talk to me, please. Why are you having such difficulty talking? Speak, 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 speak. I had difficulty talking with all the damn typewriters. Porn stars die
too. Okay, this one's tough. It's gonna kind of just spin its own wheels for a few minutes. Hang with it.
Okay. Oh, another prison. Oh, a nice prison. That's one of the white collar prisons. Alright. Let me through. Ooh, where are we heading to? The pool? Nice little hallway. Is something going to kill me? Well, I don't know. He didn't have nothing deadly in his other games. Well, not yet. Oh, that's a cool looking little, I don't know, lamp.
See, like, right. This is it. The whole game. And what? There's nothing that's particularly what? Interesting about it. You just walk to the end of a hallway.
And get trapped.
Except, for some reason, Coda gets really fixated on this prison that has all of this modern furniture. And I don't know why, but he decides he needs to revisit this prison. He's gonna start over, use the same assets, turn it into something else.
Okay.
Cool. Here's version 2.
Alright. What furniture ought to go in the center of the room? What about a TV with surround sound? That sounds nice. Hey. It's not a TV. Okay, now about along the wall of the room. Picture of a horse. I really like a washing machine. That's a couch. I think we should light up this room a bit. Skylight. Let's put a Tesla coil in the corner. Bzzz. That's not a Tesla coil. Well, not in a way. And a table. You need a table. I'm pretty sure none of these choices are going to make any difference. Boop, table. Whoa.
There's a bit more to this one, but still, it's not really communicating anything. It's kind of just weird for weirdness' sake.
Is that TV? Oh, it's a picture.
Okay, he throws it out and starts over. This time he comes at the prison idea from a different direction.
Okay. Hello, please walk forward. This guide would enable you to escape any prison environment. Follow the instructions carefully. Take care that you remember each step. Okay. First, click on this table. What's that? Good. Go over to the photo. Click to turn it slightly. Hey, it's the three holes again. Every three games. It's about every three games to see these holes. Okay. Table, picture. Now turn the floor lamp in this room off and turn it back on. Okay. Now go to the left side sofa. Move it over a little bit. Finally touch the shelves. That's it. In a real prison, the escape will now open. Return to the start to take you back to your prison. Alright. I don't know, it's like every three games we see those. I don't know. Return! Table, picture, light, couch, shelf.
And of course, now the table is gone and you can't begin the chain of events to escape.
Of course.
Here's a version where there are no bars, but you can't actually get to the well.
Okay.
And then a version where the inside of the prison is the outside and the outside is the inside.
Neat.
Let me just blink you real quick through a few more of these. I mean, he really unloaded on this prison idea. There's nearly a dozen of them. Personally, I think it's awful to watch this. To see a person basically unraveling through their work. And for what? Like, at what point do you just go, maybe there are game ideas other than this prison that I could be working on? But Coda doesn't have that voice telling you to stop. That particular mechanism of defense against yourself. Without it, you just spiral. And so he keeps going and going and going and going and going. And then he hits on something. And he likes it. And that's it. He's done. He stops making prisons. This is the very last version of the prison game that he created. And the reason I think it works is that the prison is not actually in it.
Tell you the truth, I think he may be just like creating prisons games. You know, created something and then kept on doing it. Maybe no one really cares about what he thinks. I mean, he didn't put it out. He didn't put none of his games out. He lets Davey see his games. The lamppost. Is that it? Old timey telephone booth. Well, kids, see, in the back in old days, we didn't have cell telephones. We had to take a dime and call someone. Yeah, I'm pretty sure these are going extinct and no one's really going to know what these things are. Hello? Who is this? Hey, it's me. I'm you from the prison after you escaped. I'm you from after you escaped the prison. You're me? So you were trapped in this prison too? Don't you maze?
It's a conversation. And so this is what Coda wants, is to be able to talk to someone, to share what's on his mind, and to get some good advice from someone who knows. But the irony is that even in this scenario, you're still talking to yourself. You know, all of these games so far are Coda talking to himself.
I was in the reverse prison? That's where I am right now. Oh, I'm so glad to know that I get out eventually. What's it like to escape? Actually, where are we getting? Strange, but in a way, I kind of miss being in the prison. Why? Was there anything about that you felt good about? Being here sucks. True. Maybe I only like things once I don't have them anymore. Where did three come? What? But don't you feel excited about getting out? The promise of freedom? What? That don't seem... That seems a little different from... What he was... Number three kind of throws me off. I'm gonna... True, maybe I only like things once I don't have them anymore. I do... That too, I guess. But is this just how I'm going to get... But is this just how I'm going to be forever? I really like to change that. No, I think you'll find a way to change. Wait, if you're me, then did you get a call from another version of you when you were trapped? No, I think I'm the first person to call back. Then can you tell me how to get out? Maybe I can come find you. What do I have to do? To get out, you have to be... To get out, you have to do is be Cecile. All you have to do is be Cecile. What? That will free me? How does that work? Listen, you can't know until you're out. But I promise, it works. Cecile, about what? That's exactly what you need to figure out in order to escape.
I can see why he considers this a fitting conclusion to the prison games. After all of the obsession and frustration, just to be told by someone you can trust that things are going to be okay, wouldn't that be nice?
You know, number three in a couple of backs, I was saying, that was kind of strange. Why would he be asking? I don't know.
So what would it look like if Coda wanted to make a game about talking to someone other than himself?
One, he needs someone else to do the game with him? To come up with the questions and answers? This is a cool looking little place.
To me, this environment is meant to represent Coda's puzzle, with the two doors on either side and a dark transitional space between.
Okay, that's kind of strange. Hello. Clean. Well, my goodness, I'm glad as all heck that you showed up. Thought I might be having to clean this entire house all by myself, and right miserable that would have been. Everyone knows lonely hands make lousy homes.
Is a step up from previous games, including this new and improved chat system, which he started using from this point on. From here on out, he begins putting much more effort into the visual polish of his work, and this particular game took 2 months to create as a result.
Huh. You know, this is kind of relaxing. I could just, like, sit here and listen to this. Anyway, don't worry about me. A place this nice, I'll be glad to stay here all night. But now, you just might be getting a little ahead of yourself there, no? Why don't we start by cleaning, and then you can decide whether you can stay here all night. I'll finish up here. In the meantime, could you please clear the table? Oh. Simple enough. Much nicer, that's the table I wanted to see. Now, would you please run into the bedroom and make the bed? Alright. Let me clean out here, there's a lot of mess out here. Well, you asked me to make the bed. There we go. While you're in there, why don't you straighten up the rug a bit? All the little details matter. Huh. Simple. And how did you end up doing this job? A friend dragged me along at the time when I was practically desperate for cash. Turns out I never felt so good doing something for money in my whole life. Never did like clean my own home. I might have got some demons I ain't ready to face yet. Oh, speaking of demons, someone put this couch all in a mess. Would you come out and straighten up these pillows? Speaking of demons. Oh dear, looks like someone spilled a drink over by the couch. Maybe mop that up as long as you're over there. Simple enough. I feel prepared to share an incredibly cheesy personal insight. I feel completely compelled to share an incredible cheesy personal insight. You okay with that? Okay, make it especially cheesy. No. No, it was stupid, sorry. Never mind. Hey, these dishes need to be washed. Why don't you come over? Why don't you come do that? Unless I check the tub need cleaning. How about you scrub it down as best you can? No need to be perfect. We're all just human. Oh wow, that was really nasty. Are there still books scattered on the floor in the bedroom? If so, would you put them back on the shelf? If would you mind? Okay, what do we got here? What we got here? I can't read that. Edward, I can see that. Perfect. Now then, how about you come and
after
clear the dishes
set of
off the table?
Games, this house cleaning level almost feels like cleansing. It's the moment after a particularly difficult or traumatic experience where you just need to let it sit and digest inside of you, and eventually cohere into something meaningful.
Yes, this is relaxing. Okay, close the tables off. Well, the music, you know. Do these chores ever end? Darling, let me tell you something. Whatever work you do, you have to actually got to own it, otherwise it owns you. So why don't we be with the task at hand and leave the future chores to future you?
I know that Coda really liked this game. Of all of his work, actually, this was the only one that he called me up to ask me to come over and look at it. This was during a period of a few months where he was, like, grossly happy all the time. Just walked around with a constant smile on his face.
I've got dirt again. Might clean up a bit. Well, yeah, it's just like relaxing. Just put the game on, turn the music up, and just sit back and relax. Earlier I said I had a really cheesy thought. I was going to say that it occurs to me that one's house is a bit like one's soul. You take care of it and it take care of you, huh? Don't know why I felt so real about saying that. Well, but there's a bit of truth in it, no? Anyway, so, housekeeping. Let's keep doing this. Books. Books, 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 books. What's next? Pillows.
I'm glad he made this. I'm glad he found some peace.
Question.
But
do you enjoy
it? It can't last. The music stops, your companion is gone, it's time to leave. The door at the top of the hill is now open as well. Again, you can't stay in the dark space for too long. You just can't. You have to keep moving. It's how you stay alive.
Why? Well, I don't know. They said, do you enjoy this? Actually, I kind of did enjoy it. I mean, just running around in circles doing chores, not so much, but the music is good, and there's the lamppost again.
Which is the whole point of the puzzle doors, right? That sooner or later you have to pick up and move. I really thought that was the point of it.
You did? I don't know the point to the puzzle game, but I don't... Items you love at memorable prices.
This one gets a bit goofy.
Why did you come here today? Was it to improve your life? Was it to get a better job? Was it to make your relationships more meaningful? No. You came here to become perfect. This workshop is going to teach you how to become perfect. I want your friends, the people in your life, to look at you and think, wow, this person's a better human being than I am. Right now, who do you think about that way in your own life? Who do you know who is so well developed as a person that they make you feel disgusted with yourself? Compared to whom you feel useless, selfless, ungrateful, I intend to make you into that person. Perfection is within your grasp. And the question is, how do we do it?
But about halfway through the game,
how
the
do we do
shifts.
It effortlessly? This is easy. It's so easy. It's so easy. And being perfect is effortlessness.
And you play as the teacher.
Effortless.
And suddenly, you discover that your teacher is just as bigoted and afraid as you are. Oh, and also you can move around the classroom now.
What the fuck is going on? What is going on, for real? This is On the way, I told an LA person to start to decide. Kids should not follow their dreams.
What?
Tell you right now, this animal's just effortless. This is the right answer. Wait a minute. If all you see me as being wise and intelligent, drinking is not living my life. Torturing yourself, trying to find the right solution for your life, you're not doing it right. Okay, so 3 is what he's saying during his speech, and 2 is exactly what he's thinking at the moment. And he's a little messed up, it seems. Understand that you won't be happy until you lose your pain. Seeking out the only thing one of them. I'm developing a cyst. Gross. Anyone want to do some ecstasy after this? Oh my god. I think I would. If I saw some shit like that, I'm like, let me hit that. I mean, I never done shit like that, but maybe he's on ecstasy and he's seeing that. I don't think ecstasy will actually, you know. Holy shit. You guys, something's coming out the back of the room. Look out! It's everyone, run! Yeah, I don't think ecstasy will actually. I don't know. For this one. You felt hard
like
for
one
it?
One of the most relatable experiences that you can have. To assume that some other person is perfect and totally fulfilled in every way and completely miss all of the little flaws that make them painfully human.
Huh.
I think about this game a lot these days.
No one's perfect. If you think you're perfect, then you got a problem, buddy. Okay. January 2010. Stage right.
This one took a lot longer than all the others for Coda to make. It was 4 months between this and the last one. That's twice as long as it took him to make any other game before this. And it's not like it's particularly complex, so I remember I found that a little strange at the time.
Oh, cool. Big ol' Theodore. Figaro. Figaro, Figaro, Figaro. Oh my god. Alright, the performance is beginning. Places, please. In this scene, you'll be playing as me. We are at a gathering of professionals. First, you'll start by leaning against this wall. Okay? Oh my god, it's ground. Why is it flickering like this? Leaning against the wall. I gotta look up. Good, stay right there. The woman across the room in this chair is a professional photographer of animals. It is your dream to photograph animals professionally. This is your one chance to learn something from her, to gain something to succeed. Go on, say something to her. Okay. Hello. Hello? That's it? That's not a conversation. You need to actually converse with her. Be a human being. Do it again. Well, I was being a human being. It's only option it gave me. I said, hello, you want me to talk to her? Conversation, well, that's how you start a conversation. Okay. Here's all my hopes and dreams. How about that? You want to be a photographer? No. That's not what I said to her at all. You're completely missing the turn of the conversation. I was reserved, but I knew what I wanted. I was confident. For some reason, it was just that one moment, but I was confident. Maybe it is that you need a better feeling about the settings. There were a lot of people around us. I gave you some props to work with. These cones that bounce when you touch them will represent people nearby. Now talk to her again, okay? Oh, excuse me. Pink. Pardon me, coming through. Coming through. Hold on. Dun, dun. Okay, let me see if I can hit it 4 times. Ah! Okay, you must have worked really hard to get where you are. You're messing it up again. You'll freak her out if the conversation gets that personally that quickly. Do you realize how important it was for me? I'll never get another opportunity like this again. Everything we're riding on this. Huh. I want to try something. Try stepping back from the stage. No, my bumble people. Alright. To the lamp. Okay. You want this as a destination, right?
The game ends with this eerie premonition of what's going to happen next in Coda's life. The solution to social anxiety, to fears of having to perform and having to chase success, the answer for Coda is to withdraw, to hide himself away. Which is what leads to scenarios like the stairs that slowed you down several games ago, where it just becomes harder and harder to access Coda's inner landscape because he keeps retreating. He just keeps backing away from possible connections to anyone other than himself. And to be honest, I didn't consider it very healthy when I first played this. You know, it looked to me like he was trying to justify the idea of just disconnecting yourself from the world. And that wasn't what I wanted for him or for his games. Because I feel like a lot of his games are inviting me to connect. To connect with this person. To bring him closer. But what can you do? After this, Coda went off and took another 5 months to make a new game.
Alright, well the game kept on crashing in Windows mode for some reason, but I did move to play this game properly. You must keep your eyes closed, click to begin the game. Well, like I was saying, it kept crashing in Windows mode, which made no sense to me, but probably because of the flickering lights. But I did had to replay it. Actually, I just clicked the chapter and do full screen mode. But my recorder in full screen mode, it pauses when there's loading, and it's a bitch. I mean, my audio program keeps running, but my other this program pauses. So I have to do Windows mode to actually play the games and do audio at the same time. That's why I figure out how to fix this shit. But yeah, I'm just gonna throw the video of the full screen in there. Maybe you might see a difference, maybe not, but go ahead, let's close our eyes. My ass, I ain't closing my eyes. That's how you can't play a game like that. What's going on? You're all blind. I can't help, I'm blind. Medical. That's not good. Tell me how to solve this. What's up, buddy? The only way to stop this look is something. I'm boosting creativity. I can't keep making these. My work is always fun. Well, that's a bitch.
You should probably open your eyes if you haven't already. It's pretty much impossible to solve otherwise. And there is a solution, by the way.
Yeah, I think I found it. Okay, something honest. I'm boosting creativity. My work is... Actually, the second one seems a little different from the two, so I can't keep making these. Yes, that's it. That's the truth. I don't feel it anymore.
Like I said, I was getting concerned. First off, he's never been this explicit in his work about exactly what he's thinking. So where's that coming from? But then, even weirder, his work has potentially stopped being an outlet for him. Not like he's having trouble iterating on ideas, but he literally just can't think of new ideas anymore. Hmm. And in person, he was being a lot more distant than usual. Like, you know how sometimes a person will just deflect anything that you say in order to keep themselves disconnected all the time? It was that kind of thing. Here was the point in my relationship with Coda where I really started to wonder if he needed my help in some way.
I don't feel it anymore. Keep going. Keep talking. I haven't been honest. I'm stuck in it. I have to recall it. I'm stuck in it. I don't know. We're gonna be okay. Huh.
His games are going to get more desperate from here on out.
Okay.
After this game, it's almost 6 months before he finishes something new.
Well, sounds like someone's a little down in the dumps. Oh, he's... I don't know. Maybe he can't think of anything? Okay, hello, what is this? What is this? Oh. This island come, how did you get out here? What did this island come from? Oh, this is pretty cool. The music is pretty cool also. Is that a person? How lovely. It's been a long time since I talked to anyone. What's wrong? You look lost. Okay, the first two are pretty much the same. When I try to create, I feel empty. Oh no. What happened? Did something change? It's a machine that kept me going and it stopped. Wait, you're looking for a machine? I think I know where it is. It isn't far. Take me to it.
If
I can do that, but there's a problem.
Coda talking explicitly about his creative frustrations, this one turns it up to 11. Now, put yourself in my shoes playing this. Here's a friend whose work is exhibiting signs of struggle, frustration, anxiety, depression, even. And yet, still, he keeps making games. He keeps throwing himself into the grinder even when he clearly doesn't have the energy for it anymore. Why? What is it for?
I can do that, but there's a problem. It's guarded by a difficult puzzle. If you can help me solve the puzzle, we'll find the machine. Deal? Also, number 3. It doesn't matter what I say, does it? We're going to the end up there one way or another, right? Hey, I hit 3. I did not hit 1 or 2. Perfect. Come along, I'll show it to you.
Because from my perspective at the time and just what I knew of him, this was a result of how isolated he was. He was in his own little bubble, just sitting at his computer all day, not really showing these games to anyone, not releasing them onto the internet, and so he didn't have anyone outside of himself to connect with. He had no outlet to ground himself on.
Really? I mean, I do release some videos to the internet, but a lot I keep for myself. Here's the puzzle, what do you think? That's all. Well, this is easy. Oh, wonderful. Can you tell me how to do it? First you have to open the door. Okay, now what? Now you have to close the first door. Now press the switch here. Huh, that was so simple.
You can't talk yourself out of loneliness.
This before.
It doesn't work that way.
Yes.
You can't be the one writing both the questions and the answers. Then there's no movement. Then there's no circulation. If all of your anxieties are being channeled into your work, then if the work ever fails, you have no backup and you're just going to crash.
What? Okay. Okay, here we are. What are you talking about? There's no machine here. These are just words on some wall. Trust me, you'll see. You have to say that your work is fun and easy. You have to say the game development is simple and joyous, and that you need, that you love it 100% of the time. Sure, making games are easy. Wait, what? This was wonderful, but it wasn't true. Why did the wall just crumble? Don't worry about it. Just keep talking. Keep saying that creation is easy. Okay, I feel energized. Whoa.
Seeing this game at the time that he made it, it looked really unhealthy to me. I was watching him do this to himself, and I hated it. I hated seeing him so trapped. It's like, video games are not worth this amount of suffering.
Just never start creating, you never feel bad. These are from old games.
This is someone I really cared about. And I used to get so much joy out of seeing
I'm going
him
to
create.
Vomit.
For him to suddenly become angry and frustrated like this, it was the worst thing for me.
Pain breathes effortlessly. Almost any sacrifice made for me worth it 100% of the time.
I don't know. This is what I felt at the time. I don't know how else to explain it. I wanted it to stop more than anything. I never felt so rotten. I needed more than I had ever needed anything for this to stop.
No guilt. Huh. The lamppost again. Incredible, that's it. It's me.
But it didn't stop. After finishing this one, Coda takes another 7 months and comes up with a new game.
Okay. I was trying to... The Machine. Dun dun dun. God. Madam, glad to see you arrived safely. We captured the machine. It's waiting for you now. You can begin the interrogation whenever you want. Interrogation whenever you like. I'm gonna be brutal. I intend to be brutal. Very well. To be warned, someone called the press, so they might have a bit of attention on this one. Also, what about the machine? It calls itself Coda? Wait, what?
And of course, it's the machine.
Stopped. Keeping us healthy. Wait a minute. I've been so alone. I think I understand what's going on here. Coda is the machine, and Davey keeps wanting him back to the first prison. Well, they keep arguing about what game should be playable, but this should be like the, playable pretty much, he said, right?
Apologize for leaving me. Dakota keeps taking so long to make these games. I think Davey keeps, Davey keeps forcing him to make... See, well, his games before 2009 was just... were just nothing. Alright, I apologize to people on your behalf. Was just nothing, and, there was no destination. No. Just really not really playable, like Davey wants. So... And Davey really, really wanted to know this guy because of the games he was creating. Like he said, he came on too strong. And he forced Coda to make games playable. And he don't want to do it. And that's why, like with the giant door, he say the truth. And he keeps... And he can't do it no more. Just like, the last one with the wall and everything. I keep feeling like he's gonna... Oh, what was that? What was that? My followers. Force me to deliver bad news. The machine will not apologize to us. But it's not important. We are stronger than it thinks we are. Find a way to... Davey, you have to find a way to live without it. You do not need its games. Let us show it that we are not failures. You don't need its games, Davey. You don't need Coda. Destroy the machine. Everything the machine created. Oh. Holy shit. Ah. See, Davey wanted him to make all these games, even... He even played like over the hundreds of box games, which we had nothing.
So now the work is becoming self-destructive. And I'll tell you, at the time that I first played this game, shortly after he made it, here's what I'm thinking to myself. I'm thinking that Code is stuck in his own head, and that it's having a very negative effect on him, and that all he needs to do is just start showing his work to people, to get some actual feedback on his games.
No.
It might get him out of isolation.
I don't think he wants... to show people his games. I mean,
I'm
thinking
this, I realized that I could be the one to initiate it.
Oh, no.
Because it would never occur to Coda to start actively soliciting feedback, so what if I did it for him?
No.
If he could see the difference it would make to have more actual conversations with other human beings, would that bring him out of his mental spiral?
I don't think
it
will.
Would it give him confidence in himself? Would it bring meaning back into his work?
Oh shit.
So I started showing Coda's work to people.
No.
I took this one, and the islands which you just played, the theater, the notes, the house cleaning game, and some of the prison escape games. I brought them to people that I knew and trusted. I asked their opinions. And the great part is that they really loved his games. You know, the point of it all was just to give him some external reference point, but they genuinely loved his work. There was nothing for him to be afraid of.
Put down your weapon. I think this is way of Coda telling Davey, since Davey
only really wanted to know him through his games, that he do not need these games, you know, to keep going. He's just forget about his games. That's what he seemed to be obsessed with. I mean, over 200 block games or more. Yep. That's what it seems to be.
Can you see why I felt like this was the right thing to do?
No.
It's the thing that I always feel like I need, to be told that my work is good, that I am good. When someone really connects with a thing that I've made, when they see themselves purely in my work, there's nothing that feels better. And I got to give that very same feeling to my friend. I did something
bad.
I really felt like I'd done something good. Like I was a good person. I felt like there was a friend who was in trouble and was unhappy and maybe didn't like themselves, and I could fix it. If I could give him this gift, maybe I could fix the problem. When they told me how much they enjoyed his games, it was the best feeling. It was the absolute best feeling. It made me feel so happy. So beautifully, beautifully happy.
So beautifully, beautifully happy. Yeah, that's not a creepy way of saying happy.
So anyway, Coda finishes this game, and then really he just kind of takes off for a while. So this is June of 2011, and I didn't hear anything from him for several weeks, I guess. And so out of nowhere, one day I get an email, and it's got a private link to a new game of Coda's. This one is called The Tower, and to my knowledge, it's the last game that Coda ever made. So let's take a look.
The last game that he... stop making for you, more likely, because you just wanted, like I said earlier, the game to be playable, and he just felt like making games for the hell of it. I mean, making games, The Tower, making games for making games. Like I said, I make videos for the hell of it, and I got videos that I don't even put up. You might see it in the intro to my games. You see one when I'm swimming with a shark in Battlefield. But yeah,
And this is where I have trouble saying anything meaningful about Coda's work. Because more than anything else, the tower just feels distant. It feels like it's trying to distance itself from the world. It's a very cold game.
So what is he trying to tell Davey here?
This room actually has a maze in it.
Does it?
Except that all the walls of the maze are invisible.
Son of a...
Every time you touch one of the walls, there's this awful flashing and noise. So the experience is really miserable. The game goes beyond not being meant to be played. It actually seems to despise the player for trying to play it at all. But I do want to show you the rest of the levels, so when you're ready to continue, press enter, and I'll put a bridge over the maze.
Like I said, despise the player for even trying to play it at all, because... never mind. Okay, I'm hitting her. Like I said, despise the player for even trying to play it all. When how Davey wants the games to be playable, private link to his game. I think he's fucking with you, Davey. Because this would take a... Because you would probably bother the hell out of him to make more games. And this would actually take you a
and
very...
And to be fair, it's not like this is the first game that's needed some modification to be playable. Like the house cleaning game. You know, that one used to actually loop the cleaning chores and you just cleaned a house forever. I had to cut it off so that you could exit the house and the game would actually end. But that game had an idea that it was actually trying to communicate. What's the deeper idea behind the invisible maze?
To have you not be able to get through and to leave him alone? Wait a minute. If that game kept going on forever, why was there a lamppost in it? Something tells me that Coda did not want a destination. Something tells me Davey fucked with every one of his games and put a lamppost in it.
The only way past this challenge is to randomly guess the 6-digit code. Like the invisible maze, it's frustrating to me, because it's the opposite of everything else that Coda has made. It doesn't encourage thought or engagement. It doesn't ask anything of me, except a lot of my time.
Of course.
If I could have reached him during this time, then maybe I could have asked him, but I couldn't. I still don't really understand why this is here. I'll put the code on the ground for you here, though, so that we can move on.
151617. 151617. Like I was saying, the maze, the puzzle. With just a lot of his time so he can leave Coda alone. Destination, my ass. Lamp post.
The switch to open this door is actually on the other side of the door.
What?
Meaning that it's literally impossible to solve from this side. So even if you somehow brute forced your way through the first two challenges, and you got to this point, there's actually just no way to progress.
Mm-hmm.
And it's scary for me, the idea of Coda cutting himself off entirely. Just saying, you know, that's it, that's the end of the conversation, not giving me any way to fix the problem.
Why would it have to be a problem to fix?
I feel like a failure, I guess, when I can't fix the problem.
Maybe there's not a problem.
But I can open this door for you, so let me do that.
Okay, maybe you are the problem. See, he put an invisible maze, knowing Davey will get through it. And then the impossible code.
For not understanding this game? I mean, I don't know why I would be. It's not like everything needs to have a solution. But I feel it somehow. I feel like I failed. And I don't understand why.
Failed as a friend, pretty much.
I remember. It's June of 2011. I'm playing this for the very first time. And as I'm playing, I'm thinking to myself, I don't know this person.
Of course.
I have no idea who this person is.
You just want to know him through his games.
It wasn't the guy I knew. It wasn't my friend. I had come to so many conclusions from looking at all of his work up to this point, and then suddenly none of them... I had been trying to, though. That was the thing.
Yeah.
For years, I was trying to get to know him, to understand who he actually was and what he stood for.
Through his games.
I asked him so many times to please just tell me what his games mean to him. I asked him please to tell me what the three dots mean. And he wouldn't.
You know, I think the three dots didn't show up till after Davey started playing his games. I don't remember in the first one. Well, it was in the second one, actually, so I don't know. What date was that? Was that 2009?
I just felt so strongly that if I could have connected with him, that if I could have somehow work my own, that I would finally be once and for all happy. It was that I needed to see myself in someone else. I needed to be someone other than me. But he stopped and left. And it felt somehow like I had failed.
Like you were creating the games, that's what you were thinking. So when he stopped, it felt like you failed in creating the games.
Where
is that
I
it?
Screw up?
Messing with his games. You took him. You took the fun from him. Thank you for your interest in my games. I need you to...
I'm the reason that you stopped making games, aren't I? It's because of what I did.
Uh-huh.
I poisoned it for you.
I was just saying that. Not to speak to me anymore.
I don't think I ever told you this, but when I took your work and I was showing it to people, it actually felt... it felt as though I were responsible for something important and valuable.
That's why he wanted these games playable. Because he thinks he's making up for him. You're so infected.
And the people who played them, they treated me like I was important. They really listened and cared about what I had to say. Even though I was showing your work, it was... I felt good about myself. Finally. For a moment, while I had that, I liked myself.
So is that why that little stupid puzzle was in there? Because the wall right there? Was there any answer or meaning? If there was an answer, a meaning, would it make you any happier? Will you stop taking my games and showing them to people against my wishes? Of course, like I said, give them something that is not yours to give, violating the one boundaries to keep me safe. Like I said, he didn't want that. Would you stop changing my game? Stop adding lampposts to them. I knew it. I freaking knew it. Infinite loop. Why would it be a lamppost in it?
And then you stopped. And I didn't have anything left to show people. I just had to be with myself. And as soon as that happened, there was no feeling at all. Nothing. Less than nothing. What does that mean?
Struggling to come up with new ideas is not making me depressed. Low points are just part of the progress. Of course they are. The fact you think I am frustrated or broken says more about you. Yes, it does.
I'm afraid that I did something really stupid because I don't like myself. That's why I'm releasing this collection of your work. Is because I haven't been able to find any other way to reach you. I've tried everything. And so a part of me has hope that if I put this compilation out into the world, and if I put my name on it, that maybe enough people will play it so that it'll find its way to you, so that I can tell you that I'm sorry. I know I screwed up. If I apologize to you truly and deeply, will you start making games again? Please, I need to feel okay with myself again. And I always felt okay as long as I had your work to see myself in.
Is the wall closing in?
I mean, is something wrong with me? Because I know that I did an awful thing, and I'm doing it again right now. Like, I'm showing people your work, but I can't stop myself from doing it. That's how badly I need to feel something again. Like, I'm an addict. There has to be something wrong with me. Can I apologize? What if I tell you I was wrong? Will that work? Will that fix it? I don't know. I don't think it will, but there's nothing else that I can do. Just tell me what you want. I'm sorry. Please. Start making games again. Please help me. Please give me some of whatever it is that makes you complete. I want whatever that wholeness is that you just summoned out of nothing and you put in your work. You were complete in some way that I never was. And I want to know how to be a good person. I want to know how not to hate myself. Please. I'm fading and all I want is to know that I'm going to be okay.
Well, sound like a crack at it for his games. I mean, he kind of was, wasn't he? I don't know. Epilogue. Always looking up. I kind of feel sorry for Davey in a way, but if he did his own thing just for fun, not caring what other...
More love, more praise, more people telling me that I'm good. Always more. It's like a disease.
Yeah, if he didn't care about people...
Solution.
Telling him that he likes his stuff, I mean... It is nice, you know, when you get people, you know, watch your stuff and they thumbs up or, you know, tell you it's good.
I guess if someone had told me ahead of time that he just really enjoyed making prison games, maybe I wouldn't have thought he was so desperate.
Did I say that? I think I said that.
I wouldn't have told so many people that he was depressed. Maybe he just likes making prisons.
I guess so.
Even now, the disease is telling me to stop. Don't show people what a shitty person you are. They'll hate you.
Hmm. I don't know what to say. I'll say what I think at the end of this. I mean,
if I knew that my life depended on finding something to be driven by other than validation, what would that even be?
I don't know.
It's strange, but the thought of not being driven by external validation is unthinkable. Like, I actually cannot conceive of what that would be like.
Well, I mean, you might. I don't really care. I mean, I do this for fun, just like Coda does his games for fun. And you wants to be, you know, acknowledged, validation, all that kind of...
What now?
Stuff. I don't know, man.
I think I need to go. And I'm sorry, because I know that I said that I would be here and I would walk you through this, but I'm starting to feel like I have a lot of work to do. I have a lot that I need to make up for. And so I'm just gonna... Okay.
Oh, man. Well, let's just walk through this. My, I don't know. OCD about it, I guess. I don't know. Just, I don't know. For some reason, I felt like I had to walk through it. But there's no fall damage, so that's a good thing. So I'm just walking to the end now, pretty much. Alright, well, I guess Davey's gone. Let me just say, bravo. This is a very good game. I mean, it starts off making you think, you know, I feel like it's real. I mean, he did a good job, a very, very good job in creating this feel that he's trying to get his friend to start creating games. So he's gonna, you know, throw his games out there and let you think about, you know, let you play them, what do you think about them, and try to get his buddy to come back. But then it turns very bad. I mean, all this stuff he was saying about Coda, and it's all really about him, about what he feels like Coda games should be, and I don't know, it's just, and then after, near the very end, it makes you feel kind of bad for him, this epilogue. I mean, he said he had a disease, he wants validation, he needs it. He can't think of anything else of getting. The bug kicking in. Succeeding off to heaven, to afterlife. Yeah, it just makes you feel bad for him after this. Yeah, a puzzle. I feel like the Maze Runners or something now. Holy crap. Oh, this is awesome looking. So I'm guessing this is the end. But yeah, bravo. This game is freaking awesome. I really suggest, if you haven't played this game, give it a try. Play for yourself, see what you feel about it, and I mean, if you already watched the video, you kind of got an idea of what's going on, but if you go through it again, you might be able to get a different feel about what's happening. Ah, damn, that was loud. Get a different feel of what's happening and everything, and you might look at it differently. For awe.
right. So we got the credits going.
But the cave goes for miles and miles and miles. And you're so tired. But I know that you're strong.
So turn. A lot more people worked on this than I thought. Can't sing. All right, that's the beginner's guide. Like I said, you should give it a try. Even though if you just watch the video, you might get a different feel about what's happening, what's going on. You might see some different stuff. I mean, well, not see different stuff. You might get different thoughts about everything that's happening, went on. I mean, I've done that with like other games that I played before, Final Fantasy VII. You know what happens, but then you get. You see things you haven't seen before. I mean, this is just an, I'm gonna play this game a few more times, to tell you the truth, because this game's it's awesome. I have to put it out. It's awesome, and it's deep, and I never played a game like this, to tell you the truth. Well, to tell you the truth, of course. This game just blows me away. It's a shit. I mean, anyway. Yeah, if you enjoyed the game, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to my channel. You can check out some of my older games. The PC games actually are a little bit better than the old PlayStation games I've done. But the commentary on those are not really that great. You gotta start somewhere. So, yeah. If you did like this game, go ahead and you can get off Steam and everything. You know, like I highly suggest playing it. And, yeah. Don't forget to hit the like button if you enjoy these videos. And I will see everybody some other time in another game. Alright. Peace out.